Dear students and friends, welcome to my session on Arduino. In today's session, we'll say about how to control an induction stove through the Arduino Nano board. So now is about the controlling induction stove through the Arduino Nano board. Here I'll be using showing you how to control and operate the induction stove using the Arduino Nano board actually, right? So since it involves AC current, 220 volts AC current with power of say 2000 watts, we have to be very careful. Otherwise, if there is any short circuit happens, then it will not only spoil the entire circuit, also you may experience some shock and all. Okay, so you should be safe, right? Luckily, even though we are in lockdown period, I had one old induction stove. So I use that old induction stove for this demonstration. So part list for this one is the Arduino Nano one induction stove, better a old one. And I used a Teflon sheet because it acts as an, not only as an insulator, it will withstand the high temperature also. A flat bottom stainless steel vessel, on that I'll be pouring the water and I'll be boiling it in this demonstration. Then the 4-channel high trigger relay board that I'll be using, we require this one. So again I repeat, this high trigger relay board is very important, not the road. You should not use the low trigger, you should use the high trigger. If you use low trigger, then that will mess up the entire setup actually. Then to start the initiate the working of the induction stove, switching on the induction stove, I use the line follower sensor. Again, for the safety purpose, once the line follower sends the signal, it will switch on the induction stove as per its sequence. I am not explaining about what is the sequence that this induction stove uses, because I used a old I forgot the brand name actually, Prestige induction stove. So one induction stove will be working on the on different switching action actually. Okay, so for that this is the program. Okay, this is the very simple program. If the line follower is sensed, then immediately it will switch on the power supply number one. After that, it has to press the two buttons actually. One is to switch on the control board and switching on the induction circuit. So all these things will be, I am switching on as per the sequence. After understanding the working principle of this particular induction model, I followed that way actually, right? Now I'll show you the image. Now what you're seeing now is a old induction stove. Okay, so this is the, I removed the top plate because I have to hack the system, you know. So I connected all the buttons straight away with my to the relay board, and it is connected with the Arduino Nano. Okay, so this is the line follower sensor. I think you are seeing one touch sensor also. I am not using it actually for this particular project. So this line follower is, again I repeat the sequence. Once the program is fused now, once the line follower sensed the signal, then first the power is on. After 0.5 seconds, the switching, powering on the board will happen. Then after 0.4 seconds, switching on the circuit or the switching on the induction happens. Then this will last for 18 seconds actually. I calculated 18 seconds is sufficient to boil maybe 30-40 ml water actually. Okay, so this is how. So this is the Nano line sensor, okay, for getting the input signal. This is the 4-channel high trigger relay board that I used. So this is the old induction stove. Okay, the top portion is removed. So you are seeing the induction coil and the cooling fan. Okay, now The next thing is the Teflon tape. I kept the Teflon tape. It not only acts as an insulator, it can withstand the temperature also. Then I kept a vessel here. Okay, now you just see the I'm pouring only at 40 ml water. Actually 40 ml water is poured. Okay, then now in this video, now you'll see it in real action, right? Let me quickly switch playing the video, and I'll be explain about how the things are working in sequence. Now I am powering on the Arduino through my laptop through USB cable. Now this circuit is powering, it is on now, then sensed, then signal is on. Now it is activated. Now you see it starts boiling. Now you can see the bubbles after some time. You see it started boiling. So even in 10 seconds you see the boiling of the water. So on safe side, I don't want to extend it further. That may, suppose if there is any spillage happens, then that may short circuit or that may spoil the entire setup. So I stopped it. Then another thing I introduced is, after this, even to restart the entire thing, the Arduino Nano board should be either it should be reset or it should be switched off and switched on. Then only the program will begin actually for the next cycle. For the safety purpose, I have done it so. Okay. So the program upon request I'll give you. I use this old stove for this demonstration. Now you have seen this. This demonstration is successful. Now you witnessed it in this video. Now, like that, you can control any electronic appliances through Arduino. The point is, you should understand the working principle of that electronic gadget. Once you are able to understand the concept of its working, you can easily hack, you can easily break the circuit, and you can easily attach either Arduino or even any other microcontroller. It is a step closer to automation actually. Okay, now let me tell you, connecting Wi-Fi board with this and operate it from remote places also underway. The advantage of this is, see, suppose say I'm working, and now I'm in workplace. So through Wi-Fi circuit, through my mobile phone or through internet, I can switch on this one. Once it is switched on, say for example I'm cooking a rice or boiling an egg. So to boil an egg, for example, it will take roughly say 7 to 9 minutes time. So if I set the timer, it will switch on, it will boil, and it will stop at say 9 minutes or so. Then after that, if you want to switch on the circuit, it has to be either reset or it should be powered off and powered on. Okay, so like that only I wrote a program. I wrote that program so that for the safety purpose I wrote the program that way. Okay, so there is possibilities underway now. Now through our technology business incubator, we already communicated to Chinese companies for making an add-on chip-on-board actually under the heading called ASIC, ASIC, application specific integrated circuit, for integrating this a particular brand of induction stove, Arduino and Wi-Fi all in one single module as a small capsule. If we are able to make it, then if I insert it in the induction stove as a standard electronic, then through Wi-Fi I can control the induction stove from anywhere through internet. So once it is made, it will be a new product. Okay, so that's all for today's session. So now you understood the concept of how I made use of the old induction stove, and how I did some connection with induction stove through the Arduino board, and you saw the water boiling and so on. Okay, so thank you so much. If you haven't subscribed my channel, you please subscribe my channel. So then you will get updates whenever I add a new video on Arduino or on even any other subject. Okay, and inform this to other students and faculty members, so then they will also get some inputs through my sessions actually. Thank you so much.